MCQ on Indian Evidence Act 1872, Part 9 by Deepak, Miglani. We help the students in preparation of judicial services examination. If you want to receive regular updates, please send us your mobile number through WhatsApp on 81998989 85. Question number 161. Hearsay evidence is generally inadmissible. However, in certain cases, it is admissible. Which of the following is such a case? Option A, res gestae. Option B, admissions and confessions. Option C, dying declarations. Option D, all of the above. Hearsay evidence is generally inadmissible. However, in certain cases, it is admissible. Which of the following is such a case? Res gestae, admissions and confessions, dying declarations. All options are correct. Answer is option D. Option D is answer. Question number 162. The contents of the documents may be proved by. Option A, primary evidence only. Option B, secondary evidence only. Option C, primary or secondary evidence. Option D, oral evidence. The contents of the documents may be proved by primary or secondary evidence. Option C is answer. Answer is option C. Question number 163. Which is considered as the source of superior evidence? Option A, dead proof. Option B, living proof. Option C, oral proof. Option D, none of the above. Which is considered as the source of superior evidence? Dead proof. Option A is answer. Answer is option A. Question number 164. Primary evidence includes. Option A, original document itself produced for the inspection of the court. Option B, duplicate, triplicate of a document when executed in several parts. Option C, each counterpart of a document when executed in counterparts. Option D, all of the above. Primary evidence includes original document itself produced for the inspection of the court. Primary evidence includes duplicate, triplicate of a document when executed in several parts. Primary evidence includes each counterpart of a document when executed in counterparts. All options are correct. Option D is answer. Answer is option D. Question number 165. Secondary evidence includes. Option A, certified copies of the original document. Option B, negatives of a photograph. Option C, oral account of the contents of a document. Option D, all of the above. Secondary evidence includes certified copies of the original document. Secondary evidence includes negatives of a photograph. Secondary evidence includes oral account of the contents of a document. All options are correct option. Answer is option D. Option D is answer. Question number 166. If on the carbon copies of a letter written on a typewriter, signature have been put on the first letter then other copies. Option A will also be a primary evidence. Option B will be secondary evidence. Option C will be no evidence. Option D, none of the above. If on the carbon copies of a letter written on a typewriter, signature have been put on the first letter then other copies will be secondary evidence. Option B is answer. Answer is option B. Question number 167. Mark the incorrect statement. Option A, documents should be proved by primary evidence. Option A is correct statement. Option B, oral account of the contents of a document is admissible only when given by a person who has been and read the document. Option B is also correct statement. Option D, copy of copy, if has not been compared with the original, is neither a primary nor a secondary evidence. Option D is also correct statement. Option C, a witness who has given oral evidence is not entitled to give documentary evidence. Option C is incorrect statement. Option C is answer. Answer is option C. Question number 168. A witness who is unable to speak gives his evidence by writing in open court. Evidence so given shall be deemed to be. Option A, oral evidence. Option B, documentary evidence. Option C, primary evidence. Option D, secondary evidence. A witness who is unable to speak gives his evidence by writing in open court. Evidence so given shall be deemed to be oral evidence. Option A is answer. Answer is option A. Question number 169. Secondary evidence can be given. Option A, when there is some legal excuse for non-production of the original. Option B, as a substitute for primary evidence. Option C, both option A and B are correct. Option D, none of the above. Secondary evidence can be given when there is some legal excuse for non-production of the original. Secondary evidence can be given as a substitute for primary evidence. Both option A and B are correct. Option C is answer. Answer is option C. Question number 170. In which of the following cases can secondary evidence of the contents of a document not be given? Option A, when the original is a public document. Option B, when the original has been destroyed. Option C, when the original has been found to be inadmissible. Option D, when the original is not easily movable. In which of the following cases can secondary evidence of the contents of a document not be given when the original has been found to be inadmissible? Option C is answer. Answer is option C. Question number 171. The provisions relating to admissibility of electronic records in evidence are contained in. Option A, Section 65A. Option B, Section 65A and Section 65B. Option C, Section 66. Option D, Section 67. The provisions relating to admissibility of electronic records in evidence are contained in Section 65A and Section 65B. Option B is answer. Answer is option B. Question number 172. Mark the incorrect statement in relation to Section 66. Option A, when the original document is in the possession of adverse party, then secondary evidence can be given only when a notice has been given to that party or to his attorney or pleader. Option A is correct statement. Option B, such notice shall not be required when the document to be proved is itself a notice. Option B is also correct statement. Option C, such notice shall not be required when the adverse party or his agent already has the original in court. Option C is also correct statement. All options are correct. Option D is answer. No option is incorrect statement. Answer is option D. Question number 173. How does this signature and handwriting of a document could be proved? Option A, by calling the person who signed or wrote the document. Option B, by calling a person in whose presence the document was signed or written. Option C, by calling a handwriting expert. Option D, all of the above. How does the signature and handwriting of a document could be proved? By calling the person who signed or wrote the document, by calling a person in whose presence the document was signed or written, by calling a handwriting expert. All options are correct. Answer is option D. Option D is answer. Question number 174. Mark the correct statement in relation to a certificate given by a doctor. Option A, it is a hearsay evidence. Option B, it must be proved by the doctor himself. Option C, the doctor is required to give evidence that certificate has been written by him. Option D, it can be proved only after the giving of evidence. Mark the correct statement in relation to a certificate given by a doctor. It is a hearsay evidence. Option A is incorrect statement. It must be proved by the doctor himself. Option B is also incorrect statement. Option C, the doctor is required to give evidence that certificate has been written by him. Option C is also incorrect statement. It can be proved only after the giving of evidence. Option D is correct statement. Option D is answer. Answer is option D. Question number 175. How many witnesses are required to attest a document? Option A, 1. Option B, 2. Option C, 3. Option D, 4. How many witnesses are required to attest a document? 2. Option B is answer. Answer is option B. Question number 176. Mark the incorrect statement. Option A, a document required by law to be attested can be proved under section 68 only by calling at least one of the attesting witnesses if alive. Option A is correct statement. Option B, attesting witnesses add their signature and addresses in proof of the fact that the document was signed or executed in their presence. Option B is also correct statement. Option C, no attesting witness need be called in the case of document not being a will which has been registered under the Indian Registration Act 1908 and the person executing it does not specifically deny its execution. Option C is also correct statement. No option is incorrect statement. Option D is answer. None of the above. Answer is option D. Question number 177. For proving execution of a registered will, it shall. Option B, be necessary to call at least two attesting witnesses. Option B, be necessary to call at least one attesting witness. Option C, not be necessary to call any attesting witness. Option D, be necessary to call the registrar. For proving execution of a registered will, it shall be necessary to call at least one attesting witness. Option B is answer. Answer is option B. Question number 178. If not attesting witness can be found, it must be proved that option A, attestation of one attesting witness at least is in his handwriting. Option B, signature of the person executing the document is in the handwriting of that person. Option C, both option A and B. Option D, none of the above. If not attesting witness can be found, it must be proved that attestation of one attesting witness at least is in his handwriting. Signature of the person executing the document is in the handwriting of that person. Both option A and B is correct. Answer is option C. Option C is answer. Question number 179. Mark the incorrect statement. Option A, where the party to an attested document has admitted that he executed the document, that is sufficient proof the execution even if the document is required by law to be attested. Option A is correct statement. Option C, if one attesting witness is produced, the party has done his duty under section 68 even if that witness denies or does not remember the execution of the document, and then other evidence can be offered. Option C is also correct statement. Option D, an attested document not required by law to be attested may be proved as if it was unattested. Option D is also correct statement. Option B, if the attesting witness denies or does not remember the execution of the document, its execution could not be proved by other evidence. Option B is incorrect statement. Option B is answer. Answer is option B. Question number 180. Under which section of the Evidence Act the court itself can compare the handwriting of a person? Option A, section 72. Option B, section 73. Option C, section 75. Option D, section 76. Under which section of the Evidence Act the court itself can compare the handwriting of a person? Section 73. Option B is answer. Answer is option B. Please like the video, share the video, and subscribe the YouTube channel. Thank you.